devoting one's time to one very narrow problem, which doesn't impact society noticeably, was probably not a great investment of my time. And that with the knowledge and training I had accumulated, I realized I could do a lot more good for society.
You are a jack of all trades. You know, you had to build experiments, analyze data, present results at large conferences. So you ended up picking up a broad range of skills.
You come out at 100 miles an hour, you know, and you're ready to go. And so it's taking that and channeling it in the right direction, and just learning.
Learning about the businesses, just how companies do things and what they need and what they're expecting out of computers, and more often what the computers aren't delivering, and then how we can go ahead and fix that.
In today's science, in today's engineering, in today's mathematics, you're dealing with very large data sets, and most of our clients are dealing with the same. So it's not a matter of just using data, it's a matter of being able to take very, very large amounts of data, clean it, and make sense of it so that a business executive or a business user can make sense of it as well.
The complexity is similar to what you'd see in physics when you have a large-scale optimization problem, or the kind of work that my current project is on, a hedge fund doing equity trading. Lots and lots of stocks coming at you with tons of different variables associated with each one of them. Being able to reduce that down to something requires the kind of skill set that you develop as a graduate student in physics, for sure.
One of my teammates graduated with a PhD in physics and is one of the better programmers that I've met.
If you can reason deductively, logically, analytically, you can write code. But writing code is only part of the problem. You have to be able to communicate your answers to the client in an effective way as well. And so it's analytical thinking and interpersonal skills make for great developers with us.
One of the biggest draws for me was the fact that it was a smaller company with smaller team sizes. And I came from a very small academic department, and I knew that that was a big advantage over the large, more bureaucratic departments.
This is somewhat unique. You had the intellectual stimulus of your coworkers and the caliber of your coworkers, but applying that to so many different problems, that seemed very appealing to me, rather than just focusing on one particular area.
Princeton Consultants is, in my view, is an efficient mechanism for using what academia is supposed to be training us to do, which is to make society better.